The following function gives the height of a projectile in meters after t seconds. We want to determine the height, velocity, and acceleration after 3 seconds. Before we do this, let's take a look at the graph of this function. I've already typed in the function into y1, and I've already adjusted the window as well. So we can see it's going to be a parabola that opens downward, as we see here. So if we press the trace key, the x-coordinate represents the time in seconds, and the y-coordinate represents the height in meters. So we can see as the time passes, the projectile moves upward, then at a certain point, it reaches a peak height, and then it drops downward back to the ground. Let's go back and take a look at our three questions. Well, this function is the height function, often known as the position function. So to determine the height at 3 seconds, we just need to find S(3). So we have -4.9 times 3 squared plus 15 times 3, which is equal to 0.9, and this would be meters. So after 3 seconds, the object is less than 1 meter above the ground. Now to determine the velocity at 3 seconds, the velocity function would be the derivative of the position function. Remember, the derivative of the position function would measure the instantaneous rate of change of height with respects to time. So our velocity function is going to be equal to the derivative of the position function. So by applying the power rule of differentiation, the derivative would be -9.8 times t plus 15. So now to find the velocity, we just need to evaluate this at t equals 3. So we have -9.8 times 3 plus 15. And I've already done this. It comes out to -14.4. Now the reason it's negative is because after 3 seconds, now the reason this value is negative is because it's telling us that the velocity would be downward toward the Earth. And this would be in meters per second. Again, this is the instantaneous rate of change of the height with respect to the time. And then to determine the acceleration after 3 seconds, the acceleration measures the rate of change of the velocity. So it's the derivative of the velocity function, or we could also say it's the second derivative of the position function. So the acceleration function is equal to the derivative of the velocity function, or we could say it's the second derivative of the position function. So let's go ahead and just determine the derivative of the velocity function, which we just found here in black. Well, the derivative of -9.8t plus 15 would just be -9.8. So notice how the acceleration is not affected by the value of t. So the acceleration would just be -9.8, and this would be meters per second, or meters per second squared. Now this shouldn't come as a big surprise because -9.8 meters per second squared is the acceleration due to gravity. And once this object is projected at some initial velocity, which is actually 15 meters per second, the only acceleration this object will experience is from the acceleration due to gravity. So just to summarize our findings, after 3 seconds, the object was at a height of 0.9 meters. After 3 seconds, the velocity of the object was -14.4 meters per second, which means it was downward. And then the acceleration after 3 seconds is -9.8 meters per second squared, which again means the acceleration is downward due to gravity. I hope you found this helpful.